Yo, what's up? In this video, I'm gonna show you the new charging curve of the Jaguar I-Pace. We'll compare this with an old one from, I don't remember, I think it was it this summer or last summer? I don't remember when this was, but you see this is the old one. So let's just roll it. And alright, you see that immediately, yeah, the old one, I remember the old one, you would get 100 kilowatt or 95 kilowatt just for a brief moment, usually below 10%, and then it drops to 79 kilowatt. And I tried for the longest time and it was like that, but the new one, you see, new charging curve, at least it stays at 94 95 kilowatt for a little while and then it goes up. So I'm not 100% sure if I heated up the battery properly, but I did hammer it before I went to charge it. So, but you will see that something weird is about to happen soon here on the left side there. Suddenly we get 104 kilowatts, but remember that this was done in winter recently, so I had to keep the heater on. Heater might suck up to 1 kilowatt or 500 watts, but maybe also the battery heater kicked in, plus that we were getting some decent power, I'm not sure really. But you see now, compared to the old one, which only got 80 kilowatt, then this is a nice upgrade, very very nice, right, okay, well, is it really nice? We'll see then, because you see that this is what I've been trying to find, trying to record for the longest time. Every time they said, oh, there's a new update, the H280 update will fix it. And then I tried it. I think it was the one, the car to the right here. And it was still charging, you know, not faster, or I wouldn't say slow, but 80 kilowatt is still decent, I guess, even today. But when we get close to 40% now, you will see that the new charging curve also starts throttling a little bit. So very nice and flat curve. Another thing you'll notice is that the voltage is actually, well, the voltage now to the left side is higher because the voltage is depending on charging speed also. You see that now that the charging speed dropped, then the voltage also drops. But it seems like the old car had higher voltage. I'm not sure. I'm not 100% sure. I was trying to find the same power, the same state of charge. But you see that at this point, it starts throttling also with the new one. So if you look at 20-minute mark, 45%. Okay, let's wait for the other one to pass 45%. But we have to look at the timer on the left side, because the right side we started below 10%. So don't look at the timer and the kilowatt hour on the right side. There, 23. So you see, it's about 2-3 minutes slower now, or the other way. I mean, the new charging curve is about 2-3 minutes faster to 45%. But then on the other hand, who charges to only 45%, right? So we should try to measure maybe. Yeah, you know, when I did 1000 kilometer challenge, I tried to charge to about 60-65%. I calculated that to get there fastest, you actually have to charge between 55 and 65%, but then charging every 55% is kind of cumbersome. So usually what I did was to unplug at around 60 or 65%. You see that it's still okay speed. Let's say, I mean, 66 kilowatt for an Ioniq would be wonderful, but this car is kind of thirsty. So let's say around 60%. Okay, 60%, 31 minutes. Okay, let's time it now and see the old one. There you see, the old one is right behind it. And what's happening now? Because the new charging curve had an advantage, but then suddenly it seems like the advantage has been eaten up. And you can actually see that the old curve is flat. And this is, it's not the first time I see this, because I've seen Tesla do exact same thing, that with a 100 pack and a 75 pack, that you guys remember that suddenly people were reporting 150 kilowatt peak, and also the 75 pack would suddenly peak at 135 kilowatt, and they could only get 100, 110 before. But when I actually recorded the whole charting session, it turns out that yes, Tesla did give you higher peak power, but if you want to charge to, let's say, 70%, that is common for people to charge to, then it was actually slower than before. And we start seeing it now that, you see, the old car had 60 kilowatts, but now we are only getting 50 kilowatts. So what the heck is going on here? Basically, what I mentioned is that most of the time, at least I would charge to about 65-70%, and then I go to the next one, because now it's starting to charge a little bit slow, especially if a car that is kind of thirsty like this, you know. So which means that the new charging curve isn't that much faster really, because okay, if you really want to rush it and you only charge it 45%, but then you have to charge every 100 kilometers, then yes, you will save a couple of minutes every time And it's barely okay. It eats up, almost eats it up with the overhead because you have to stop more often. So it depends where you stop and charge, I guess. And also, you better have high power charger support, because if you don't have, then yeah, it's the same as before. So you will actually see that the old charging curve will finish faster than the new one. Now I don't know exactly if these two batteries are the same capacity, but at least what I noticed is that. The one to the left, the new one, it's branch banking new, so there is about 2 kWh of hidden capacity on the very top. Yeah, that is very important because it's past 100%. It just goes, it still charges past 100% and fills up about 2 kWh more. So that means that these two charging scales, or you know, these two percentages should be possible to compare, because I believe that from 100% down to 0% in both left and right is around 81.8 kWh. That's what I've been measuring over and over again. But you see now, this is a huge difference, because the right side is about to finish there. It took 59 minutes to go to 90% before, but you will see that now it takes more than an hour. So in the end, it will be about it's 7 or 8 minutes slower than before. But this is not too relevant, because I don't think too many iPace owners charges to 90%. Actually, most EV drivers don't charge to 90%, maybe except for cars with fairly flat charging curve like e-tron and i3s. That's the two cars I can think of right now that would charge to 90%. And okay, Tesla charges really fast, so usually if you have a food break, then you might reach 90%. But even for Tesla, I usually don't charge to more than about 70-75%, and then the hammer to the next one there. Okay, so now the next one I'll show you is a charging graph between these two, and you see that interestingly it would appear like we can charge, I mean, that the charging should be much faster, right? Because you have a pretty nice dip, I mean, pretty nice flat top there on the bottom, at least until about 40% or 38%. But like I mentioned, I'm not sure if some of this is, battery heater, because, you know, remember that the display you saw, that is what the charger delivered. And then what goes into the battery is a different case. Then we need to look into a BMS or something, and this car doesn't show it. So it might just be that 5 kWh of the top here is battery heater activated. So maybe we are only getting 100 kW. That could be the case, because Jaguar never said that they will charge more than 100 kW. They just said 100 kW, not 105 kW. And then you see that past around 50%, then the old one had a much nicer and flatter curve. And this is the reason why the old one finished to 90% faster. And another theory I have is that when the car is charging at higher C rating, you know, when the charging speed is like, let's say 90 to 100 kW, then you might have, I mean, you have more losses. So, you know, by pushing the power to higher, not too high, but higher than this, then you have more losses. And that means that you are just you're just sucking more power from the charger to charge a little bit faster, which is of course nice, but you also have more losses, and you might be able to scavenge it from the battery if you start driving right away. If you don't start driving right away, what might happen then is that is that it will start cooling down the battery, which means that the heat is lost. But also, you see, the old curve was flatter, which means that you have lower loss, and then at high state of charge, I guess it's not that you don't generate too much loss at high state of charge versus the lower power. So I think actually many people would prefer the old charging curve even. I'm not sure about that, but at least I show you now the before and after. And a little disclaimer is that, okay, yes, it might not have been 100% ideal battery temperature in the new charging cord because it was winter, but I did try my best. I did yo-yo, I did hammer it before, so the battery should be very warm. And if I tried another charging session, maybe it would be slightly better. We might be talking about 30 seconds to 1 minute faster throughout the whole span here. So yeah, I think that's gonna be it for this one. Yeah, So yeah, I hope you guys enjoy this video. As always, thank you for watching and talk to you later.